like to welcome you to Music Meditation Minus Munchies Miles Apart today. We have a wonderfully festive program for you today, and this is back to a time when life was a lot less complicated. We have music by Telemann, Scarlatti, and Handel, who wrote in the beginning of the 1700s. So I'm hoping that you can transport yourself back to that time and put aside all of the other things that are going on in the world today. I am really thrilled to work with Angela Calabrese and Jeff Stempien. We have collaborated before, and we've always had a lot of fun, and today is no different. I'm also so pleased to welcome Father Thomas Mull, who will offer the meditation today.
I want to thank Molly for inviting me to be here this afternoon. And I begin with those words of gratitude, because what I'd like to focus on is gratitude, and in a few moments, I think you'll understand why. I'm going to begin with a reading from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion, and the God of all encouragement, who encourages us in our every affliction, so that we may be able to encourage those who are of any affliction, with the encouragement which we ourselves have been given by God. For as Christ's sufferings overflow to us, so also through Christ does our encouragement to others overflow. If we are afflicted, it is for your encouragement and salvation. If we are encouraged, it is for your encouragement, which enables you to endure the same sufferings that we suffer. Our hope for you is firm, for we know that as you share in the sufferings, you also share in the encouragement. In the Catholic tradition, November is always a month of gratitude, and we are invited to take time during the month, pretty much like Molly just said, in letting go of things and sitting back for a moment and being grateful to God. Part of that origin, of course, is because November is harvest time, or just after the harvest, and a lot of the summer's work is done. And it is time to simply enjoy life and be grateful. And I was thinking that in these days, with the pandemic crisis still very much alive among us, the challenges of trying to remain safe, trying to follow all the protocols that we have to follow, and trying to be sure that we aren't carrying anything that we might share with others that might make them sick. It is a time when we feel particularly challenged. But I have found, as St. Paul said in the opening of his letter to the Corinthians, that even in times of challenge, or as he says, affliction, we find much to be grateful for. I went back for myself, and probably some of the greatest challenge that I've had is the fact that I've had cancer, and the cancer has returned three times. And in between each of those, I've had treatments for that cancer. And any of you that have had that know that that is not a very good experience, although in my case, it has been very good because I'm once again in remission. But as I think about that, to be honest, I don't even think of the treatments. I don't think of the side effects that, I've had. But what I'm very well aware of and very grateful for are the many, many people that have been there. Many of them I'd never met before, but people who encouraged me, people from my own parish who promised their prayers for me, people who offered rides and offered food, but I have to say food was not something I really wanted during those days. But it was that sense that even in some very challenging moments, when sometimes you wonder if you aren't better off dead than alive, there were people there. And I'm very grateful for that. And I'm very grateful with the fact that with my memory, when I think back on these past years, those are the things that I remember. And it sort of says to me, as Paul said to the Corinthians here, that when we find ourselves joined with the sufferings of Christ, we actually become stronger. And when we find our strength in Christ, then we become deeply aware that God is never apart from us. So as we come here this afternoon and continue to live out these days of gratitude in November, as we come here this afternoon to hear the joyous music and sort of be caught up in this short experience, but none of us experience that as a gift to us. It is an opportunity to sit back, to move with the rhythm of the music, to be grateful to God for the gifts and the things that He's offered to us, but then to be reminded that we are to carry these gifts forward, that we look backwards for a while, but we have to live the future. But as we go to the future, we do so with hearts of gratitude, with the joy of music, with our faith that tells us God is always with us, and with prayer. So let us pray. Lord Jesus, as you accepted suffering and death for us, so through that affliction that you suffered, you brought us resurrection and new life. From what we have seen, we know that your love overflows for us. And as we gather here today to celebrate the wonderful gifts of these people who are sharing with us, we do so confident of your love, confident of your concern for us, and confident of that challenge you give us to be concerned for others. Bless us during this month. Help us appreciate who we are and what we have, and always remind us of your loving presence. Amen.
Thank you.